Hey everyone, this is Will with RCBS, and today I'm going to be discussing tips to get the best results from your new ChargeMaster Link. The Link was designed to be the most affordable dispenser from RCBS, while still delivering best-in-class accuracy and speed. With some pointers from our decades of dispenser experience, we'll help you get the best results possible. One of the first key things to remember is digital scales and dispensers are very reliable devices. With that being said, some things can cause inaccuracy that you need to be aware of. Change in temperatures. If the temperature in your reloading room fluctuates more than a few degrees, the scale will need to be recalibrated. Allow the scale to stabilize for 20 to 30 minutes to get acclimated to the new environment. Always try to keep a constant temperature while using any dispenser. Always give the scale 20 to 30 minutes to warm up before first use, or if the scale has been off for longer than 30 minutes. Keeping the powder pan on the platen during warm-up helps allow the load cell to stabilize. Unlevel working surfaces. You need to ensure your link is as level as possible. Use the adjustable feet and bubble level to ensure the unit is level. Uncentered weight on the platen. All pans and calibration weights should be centered on the platen. This will ensure the weight on the load cell is accurate and consistent. Be mindful of the cover and only use while dispensing if absolutely necessary. If you're operating the unit outdoors or in an area where a draft is present and your measurements are getting errors, the cover is necessary, but make sure that you calibrate the unit with the cover on. Otherwise, different measurement readings will result. Different values with the cover are caused due to static charge buildup on the cover. When the scale is not in use, be sure to keep the cover on as it will protect the platen and load cell. Make sure any items around the scale that could create electric interference are not close. Some of these items could include radios, speakers, fluorescent lights, and even magnets. If the scale is hit or jarred during operation, verify calibration is still correct by placing a calibration weight onto the platen. If the displayed weight is incorrect, recalibrate and start loading again. Use only the provided calibration weights supplied for accuracy. The top knob threads into the calibration weight, and there is material inside the cavity to ensure the calibration weight meets standards. Ensure this knob remains secure and is not removed, as the internal weights could fall out, changing the actual calibration weight. Keep calibration weights as clean as possible and properly stored. If they're dropped or damaged, they need to be checked against a known standard. Please contact our customer service for help. Static electricity can cause the scale to jump around. If there is static buildup, wipe the scale with an anti-static sheet or use an anti-static spray. If you decide to use an anti-static spray, spray onto a clean, dry cloth and wipe the scale reservoir hopper and area around the platen. Do not spray directly on the machine, as this could get into the mechanism. If powder gets inside the unit, stop operation immediately and do not use the dispenser until it has been serviced. Contact RCBS customer service for help. Do not press on the platen with your hand. This can damage your load cell. Only use with smokeless powder. Do not use with black powder. Always empty powder out of your unit when you're done with the loading session. Keeping the unit loaded with powder could cause the plastics to deteriorate. It is also best to keep your powder sealed airtight as much as possible. You can use the included brush or compressed or canned air to blow residual powder from the reservoir tube prior to storage, just to make sure all the kernels are out of it when finished with the loading session. However, if you use compressed air, make sure to keep the nozzle at least 12 inches away so you're not blowing directly on the display. Always ensure that you store your unit in a clean, dust-free environment with the wind and storage cover in place. If your powder flow rate increases, causing overcharge conditions, use a small nylon brush and run through the tube about 10 times. This will increase the friction and slow down the powder flow, reducing the overcharges. This may need to be done after every 10,000 rounds. If you brush too much, the flow rate will slow even more. However, it'll resume to a steady state generally within 100 dispenses. Do not use a solvent or any cleaner, as you want to have some residue in the bore to reduce friction. If you follow these tips and suggestions, you'll be able to get the most accuracy out of your ChargeMaster Link. If you would like to find out more information on the RCBS ChargeMaster Link, visit us online at rcbs.com.